Hello Promising Traders, Alex here from PromisingTrader.com with Digibyte on my chart. The timer has started. This is only paper trading advice, not real money. Please do not put your money just because I'm saying money may go there. Do your own due diligence. If you want to start learning how to do your own due diligence and making constant small profits, even daily if you want, that's trading, you can watch the video in the top right corner right now. I will show you how to start up with TradingView for free. It's a completely free thing you can use, and you can register to TradingView with the link below in the description and even in the pinned comment. And I will show you how to start up, how to set it up, how to place orders, paper trading orders, so you won't risk anything, but you will start learning the mechanics of these things, because the technical analysis is very interesting. At least I like it, that's why I'm doing two videos every day. So, and also I will show you how to use and configure in my candle scanner, which you can get again for free. You need to just join the Promising Traders tribe. Along with the candle scanner, I will give you my advice. I will share with you some of my strategies with Forex, but it really doesn't matter. Forex is very similar to crypto, because in this time I am focusing on Forex, so I'm not trading crypto. And you will see how to configure it, how to tweak it, how to use it, and it will show you when a reversal pattern occurs. In the future, it will also show you continuation patterns. So you will use this tool to determine whether or not you want to join, enter a trade or not, and what position you want to take, either bullish or bearish, so that you can make money. And you will see your paper portfolio either growing or dropping. That's very useful. Now, monthly view for Digibyte. Nothing has happened yet. I mean, it's completely like yesterday to me. Let's check the weekly. In the weekly, I don't remember yesterday, maybe it was green. This is a red doji, but still it's a doji, so meaning that there is no action in these two time frames, and it's impossible to tell you anything except for the fact that we already know we don't want the 55 to cross the 233 in here. That would be very, very bad and very scary. So in order to prevent this from happening, Digibyte has a few weeks, let's say until the end of the year probably, to go back to 1 cent, above 1 cent. We need to have Digibyte trending above 1 cent. If it doesn't, this will cross. And then I'm afraid it will keep crossing, it will keep dropping, probably, if it can, because it's already very low. But yeah, it can indeed. And let's check in the daily instead. In the daily, we had three confirmations, actually, like I already said, 1, 2, 3, that this is a support area. Let me just reveal all the mess. Let's see. Boom, 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 boom. Okay. Three confirmations. The thing that I like to see is that for each confirmation, so that there are reversal patterns, bullish Harami, Morningstar, maybe because this is crypto, yes, I would say Morningstar, but this is a bullish engulfing candle, with RSI trending anytime higher, every time higher, and MACD has made the crossover, so this is going to probably rally a little bit, but we have a major issue here, because, like I say all the times, the more powerful than the reversal signals in with the charts, with the candles, these arrows, this name that you see here, are windows, are the gaps. And this gap here was not closed. This gap here was not closed. Digibyte in the 6 hours must close above this and above that. That it means literally it must do a crossover of the 233 EMA, really. And it should start trending probably in the area of nearly 1 cent at 0.008-ish. Okay? And this hasn't happened yet. And that's a concern to me, even though checking MACD, sorry, I just didn't comment. The crossover that looked like it was about to happen really badly didn't happen, which is what I think I was saying. And so I'm very optimistic about the fact that it's going to make the crossover. Also, yesterday and before yesterday, I was saying that it was going to drop and test how much? 6769? Yeah, this area here, 0069, there it went. And then we had a confirmation, and then we had another, this in this case, bullish window, this gap here now, theoretically, functions as these two. So this is our support, theoretically. If Digibyte closes in the 6 hours below that support, that's gonna be very, very bad. So we don't want Digibyte to close below this, we want Digibyte to close above those. Okay, for the same reason, this inverted hammer with the confirmation, this is also a morning star, quite frankly, is completely useless if Digibyte closes below it and goes simply for a retest of it. It's completely useless. It's going to mean drop. Price is going to drop. Okay? Now, let's go in the 3 hours and let's try to figure out how things work. In the 3 hours, it's fine if it closes here. It doesn't have to close in the 6 hours, okay? Like in here. In the 3 hours, if it closes there, it's not enough. It needs to close there in the 6 hours. Now, we had bull engulfing. This is not a bull engulfing candle. This is something that I have never seen in cryptocurrencies. This is a separation line, I think it's called, where the price opened here and closed here, but the next candle, the price opened at the previous closure. In fact, I think I have it set, but not for crypto. It doesn't even work for cryptocurrencies. Wow. And goes up. So basically closes here, open at the previous open price and goes up. This is very bullish to me. So this bear engulfing candle is absolutely nothing, and you will see this now going higher. This is a very nicely bullish pattern. And now I may be wrong, but I don't think this is going to drop, quite frankly, even though now we are seeing this shooting star. But I'm sure we still have 3 hours for this candle. I'm sure things will change, and actually we can try and see now what's gonna happen in here. If we go in the hour, well, in the hour it's actually showing many bearish signals, but well, these candles have never been like this for since a long time. They are all overlapping each other more than usual in the hour. I'm just trying to see, look at this gap, how beautiful. I love that. So in the hour we had nothing. It's still within the gap. So we have another one here. I'm not going to draw it because it's impossible, because they will merge together. But basically, in the hour, we don't want Digibyte to literally close below this green line, which is 0.0071. This one here, you see, 0.0709906, this one. We don't want it to close here in the next hour. You will probably not, in 40 minutes, actually, well, in the hourly time frames, you will probably not see this because I still need to upload the video. But however, we have a little bit of an interesting situation here. Now, there is definitely a bullish value here, not extremely bullish, but I like what I'm seeing here in RSI. MACD though is looking like it's crossing over. I don't know if it will, because it may change. We still have like 40 minutes to do that. But yeah, what we don't want to see is in the hour Digibyte going inside this window here. Okay, so that's what we don't want to see. And you see, the thing is that it's just fighting for the 233 MA, and you can tell it's holding on the 55. So hopefully these piercing pattern, which is not a piercing pattern actually, hopefully what we see here in the action will hold on the 55. Let me go and check Digibyte Bitcoin now. I think it's not moving much either. Let's go in the daily. In fact, it's not moving much. It looks like it's about to explode, but I wouldn't trust it. I think it's going to drop a little bit before. Exactly like yesterday, Bitcoin is not moving, anything else is not moving. That's it, that's the truth. And again, like I keep saying, we may expect a retest of this area before the rally, but it will rally, I am sure, because Bitcoin is about to drop. So that's it. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. Please let me know what you think. Like, share, and subscribe. Thank you for doing that. I know you do that. YouTube sends me the email and says that many people have shared my videos, and I really appreciate it. It's thanks to you that the channel is growing, so I'm really very grateful to you. And nothing, let me see. I will try to do Doge on top of this three videos is a lot of time, because I understand that you don't want me to alternate. Just one person. I am sorry. I need to make choices for the majority. I will try to add Doge sometimes, maybe whenever I have time. Unfortunately, not this week because I really am extremely busy. But I will try and make it. Okay. Thank you very much for watching. I wish you a great day, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye bye.